Nice.
What's your real name?
We're an exclusive right now.
No, it's top secret.
Jonathan Pepper. Is that it?
No.
Am I right?
No.
Nearly?
I'm playing at the Electric Ballroom tonight.
So you got like the biggest show out of the whole thing?
It's a big venue. Hot, sweaty fun. I'm be doing festivals of summer, Glastonbury and Wireless and Global Gathering and hopefully festival and doing some touring and going to Europe, going back to the States. I'm playing Coachella next weekend with Mark Ronson, which should be effing brilliant. When I was a kid, I ate some blue chocolate and I did a blue turd. I'm from Sydney and I've kind of lived all around the world. I moved to LA with my family when I was 10, and then when I was 17 I moved to the UK, and since then I've moved back around all 23 places.
So which do you prefer, LA or London?
Well, they're both different. I think I need to just keep going back and forth because they both satisfy me in different ways. Obviously the weather sucks here, I have to say, but it's really fun, the music's good, the sense of humour's good. Good beer.
Where do the balls go when you wear a little?
I just have to pick a side. Psycho killer,
qu'est-ce que c'est? Russ Tannen for Outmore Television with Toddler T.
Hey.
Let's go!
Played a killer set, Camden Crow.
Jokes.
Killer. I lost my mind. I was busting some moves.
It's a manoeuvre.
Enjoying a little bit of time in London, but you're here all the time.
I might as well get flat.
Yeah. Thinking about it?
Nah, I did. Nah, man. Home is where the heart is, man. If I move here, I'll be playing electro in Shoreditch within 3 weeks.
Really? 2 weeks? Is that all you give yourself?
I'll be sucked in.
Do you off the booze?
For a bit, yeah.
But you live in Sheffield, so is it hard not to drink up there?
Why would it be hard?
What else will you do?
Make tunes, don't you? Sheffield's cool for music, man. For making music, it's amazing. Like, the crew's come out of there. Living proof.
I just opened an academy.
Yeah.
Which is good.
You played that?
Yeah, on the opening night. Yeah. 2,500 people. It was bizarre.
That's enough, isn't it? All there to see you?
No. Really not. Reverend in America's warm up. Supposed to be doing some stuff with him. See what happens.
What sort of stuff? Songs?
Music.
Just got some just stuff.
Yeah, just tunes.
You've got a new single coming out? Is that what you're doing it?
Sound tape, Killing is the next single, yeah. Next month. Video is out now. Look on YouTube.
Seen it? People should watch it.
Damn!
You're feeling the 1965, love. And you've got, there's a bunch of other bands on that roster. Are they bands that you know before you were on there? Or is it a new whole thing for you, like the indie sort of bands that were there?
Totally new. I'm not going to lie, I didn't like indie for years. And then Metro's changed me. Yeah. I've seen them a few times and thought, yeah, bad. And then since that, since getting into them, I've opened up massive them with a few other bands now. And big.
I don't get the hey thing, man. Do I need to, will I catch up?
Just hang around.
2 weeks' time, there'll be an Oatmeal TV special. I'll be like, hey, to all the bands. And they'll be like, what are you talking about? I'll be like, talk to Todd T, and then you'll know what I'm talking about.
There you go. Just spread it, man.
Safe. Yeah, hey.
I've hunted down and found Youth Movies.
What's up with the way you look?
Oh, I got killed by a chainsaw.
So the new album, Good Nature, has come out.
Right.
I did buy that.
It's more melodic and stuff.
Yeah.
I think it's less juvenile.
Cool.
We were kind of more confrontational then.
Oatmeal TV.
Yes! Who the hell is this?
We are Team Water Polo.
Tell us a little bit about your name. I'm a bit baffled by the name Team Water Polo.
That's my bad, yeah. The name. Yeah.
Stuck with it now.
It's just random, you know, thoughtless words put together.
We get random people on MySpace that have no interest in the music but are water polo players. They seem to have a really keen interest.
Hey! So what you got coming up then, boys? What are you doing?
We're touring with Air Traffic after this. That starts next week. Yeah. Then we've got the Enemy Nuno East tour in May.
Oh, amazing. Who else has done that?
Crystal Castles, Friendly Fires, and a band that we played with before called White Lies.
How does that feel to be in a band that's sort of getting a bit of buzz going and everyone's talking about you? And, you know, how does that feel? Yeah, it's good.
Amazing. It's all still, like, really new to us. So it's better than no one really talking about you.
Yeah. Yeah, we were in high school together, and we were in a band called Effigy in high school, And it was just a...
It was new metal.
Yeah, it was new metal. It was terrible.
Did that lead on to Team Water Polo then? Was it quite natural? No, no, you had a bit of a break.
Relevant from Team Water Polo.
Korn covers or anything?
We did cover Blind. We covered no, we this. Covered Blind for the first year.
Are you ready for Team Water Polo?
Good afternoon. I'm here with Brad and Matt from Cage the Elephant. How are you guys doing today?
Doing good.
Yeah?
Brad, you doing good?
Yep.
Cool.
Doing good. He seems kind of sad this morning. Brad, are you okay, Brad?
I was like, nothing's wrong.
You're brothers, right? Am I wrong?
Yeah,
am I right?
Yeah, we're brothers. But no, his wife is here, so that'd be kind of weird if I slept with him.
Yeah.
It's just your first time over in London. London town. Foggy London town.
We've been here since September, like, yeah. Off and on.
We played... Coco's probably my favorite. People get crunk in Croco, yeah, man.
I went to San Francisco once, and they're all going, "Oh, we're getting hyphy tonight." I don't know what it meant, but someone explained.
We live in the South, so we're always behind on all this terminology.
Yeah.
So, what have you guys got out on like record at the moment? What's going on?
We got one of our singles out in one ear, and then "Ain't No Rest for the Wicked" should be out very soon.
"Ain't No Rest for the Wicked." You actually use the word "ain't."
Yeah,
I use the word "ain't" every day. We're from.
Hey, Bob Dylan used the word "ain't," and damn it, I can too.
Lead singer of Cage the Elephant rocked so hard he blew out his pants.
I ran up, and I jumped onto a speaker stack, and my pants and the crotch exploded. My pants right here just went boom, and I was like, "Oh no!" Because it was like the second song, I couldn't run off stage and like change my pants or anything. So like, I just had to sit there, and keep going.
He was
man.
Crowd surfing. He said he saw some guy go like this. Whoa! No.
We got all kinds of messages on MySpace too saying, "I saw your balls." And I was like, "That's cool."
Were they silky smooth?
They were smooth as eggs.
I don't know why I'm asking you about
your balls.
Smooth as eggs.
Thanks for your time, guys. Cage the Elephant, Cameron and Crawl.
Thanks
Cheers.
Thanks for having us, man.
Oatmeal Television, Enter Shikari.
He's got really nice shoes.
Have you ever done a gentleman's lunge?
We're going to get the whole crowd to do their lunges before we kick off, you know. We don't want any injuries.
Well, we're writing a new record at the moment, actually. It's going to be wicked.
Don't like porridge, but I love oatmeal.
Oatmeal Television.
Oatmeal. I'm not pregnant, by the way.
You hang up.
Thanks for watching this episode of Oatmeal TV. Bad.
Good afternoon. I'm your friendly neighborhood zombie.